This is Giardia. It was first identified by Anton von Leeuwenhoek, the inventor of the microscope, when he found it in his own stools in 1681. For almost the next 300 years, it was considered to be a harmless microorganism. It wasn't until 1970 that it was identified as the cause of the intestinal distress in 200 million people around the world every single year. It's the single most common waterborne pathogen in the world, and it's an example of how the press can cause irreparable damage to the reputation of an individual, or in this case, an individual species, namely the beaver. In the early 1970s, campers at Banff National Park in Canada got sick after drinking water from a stream. The illness was attributed to the beavers living upstream, and the press then dubbed it beaver fever, forgetting the fact that Leeuwenhoek found it in his own stool, and millions of cases around the world take place where there are no beavers. Neither he nor most of the other 200 million people a year who succumb to the illness were anywhere near a beaver. But there's much more to show that the beavers are getting a bad rap. We know that Giardia is found in 90, yes, that's right, 90 different animal species, which includes a variety of birds, reptiles, amphibians, fish, mammals, which include humans. The disease is contracted by ingesting feces-contaminated food or water. The underdeveloped countries where poor sanitation exists, somewhere between 60 and 100% of the population carries or suffers the parasite. Even in the United States, where the sanitation is much better, Giardia is found in municipal water supplies and identified as the source of most outbreaks. In the United States, from 1971 to 2011, 76% of all waterborne outbreaks were associated with drinking water and 24% with recreational water. Of the recreational outbreaks, three-quarters of them were linked to swimming pools and wading pools, leaving 6% to ponds and lakes. There are no statistics that would determine how many of these could be attributed to toddlers as opposed to beavers, but the next time you go to your local lake or pond, count the number of toddlers and dogs that you see compared to the number of beavers you might think that there are around. And you'll know why no one has done that particular study. The press did it. Beaver fever still exists. In the United States, two of the waterborne outbreaks, accounting for 8,449 cases, were attributed to water parks. And when was the last time you saw a beaver in a water park? A single non-symptomatic toddler with Giardia can infect an entire swimming pool. It's estimated that Giardia was found in 100% of the surface water in the world. Considering all this, perhaps a better name for beaver fever might have been diaper disease or loose louisitis or maybe the water park pukes. But come on now, let's give the beavers a break.